So welcome students for our review on catalysis. We agreed upon that catalyst is a substance which increases the speed of a reaction without itself undergoing a permanent chemical change. I think you know that a catalyst works by lowering energy of activation and it provides a simple path for the reaction to proceed. And you know that a catalyst can never start a reaction. It can speed up a reaction that has already been started, nor it can change the amount of products, also the enthalpy of a reaction. And you know there can be homogeneous, heterogeneous catalysts as we have seen in the previous session. But there are some catalysts in living systems, they are called enzymes. Roughly there are about 3000 enzymes. They are such wonderful catalysts. They make certain very, very difficult reactions happen just at the body temperature. The optimum temperature where they work is around 310 K, and at the ordinary pressure of 1 atmosphere and at the body pH between 5 to 7. These enzymes are very, very efficient, you know. A very small dose of this colloidal enzyme that can speed up the reaction of 10 to the power 6 molecules per second. And they are so specific, like a lock and key. Every lock has a specific key. Like every enzyme is specific for a particular reaction. And they work at an optimum pressure, optimum temperature, optimum pH. And the non-enzyme part that is present in an enzyme sometimes is called coenzyme. For example, Na plus is a particular ion associated with amylase that speeds up its activity. And you know that enzymes are colloidal particles. They have certain cavities and they have a characteristic shape. And the active group in an enzyme appears to be either amine group NH2 or COOH or alcohol OH group or thiols SH group. All these sites are active sites of a particular enzyme. And to this active site, the reactant molecule we call substrate binds to that. And then it goes to a particular state, activated state. From there, it converts itself into a product. When once it becomes the desired product, it gets desorbed. Again, the surface is available for reactions to happen. All this we can present as enzyme plus substrate gives ES complex. ES complex immediately converts itself into a particular product and then gets separated as enzyme and product. Again, enzyme is ready for attack on the new substrate. In our system, there are as many as, see, invertase is an enzyme coming from yeast that can convert sucrose to glucose and fructose. And you have so many enzymes like zymase. Invertase, zymase are actually involved in the production of alcohol from sugar waste. And they have specific roles to play, as you can see in this table. Diastage is helpful to convert malt. It is generated from the germinating barley powder. Malt, and then it can convert starch to maltose, and again this can be used in alcohol industry. Maltase is another enzyme. Generally, name of enzymes end with H, and the sugars on which they work end with O's. Some urease can be obtained from soya bean that can convert urea into ammonia and carbon dioxide. So pepsin, trypsin, amylopsin, so many enzymes are there in the stomach which work in acidic medium and convert proteins to amino acids, so on. And please notice that an enzyme is especially highly efficient, and enzyme has so many characters that they are specific in reaction, they are highly active under optimum temperature conditions, so on. So now we are wondering, the other highly active, increasing activity in presence of activators or coenzymes, and under the influence of some inhibitors or poisons, they will render inactive. These are the active groups they have. And the mechanism can be picturesquely presented that this is having some particular block into which the enzyme offers, you know, something able to bind to substrate. When once they bind together, the substrate changes into product. Product cannot fit into this block that gets eliminated. Well, this can be understood easily. Now, our main interest is to see some problems in coming 2 minutes, whether you can solve them. Let us see, most I believe that you can address them. This is what we are planning for coming 2 minutes. The temperature at which the catalyst activity of the catalyst is maximum is called, of course, optimum temperature. The decomposition of KClO3 is catalyzed by, can you think, answer is, I will just show the questions, you think it over the answers and then I will just display them. We are starting with question number 15. Look at these questions to yourself. It is a good exercise for you. Let us start here. This is question number 18. Yeah. In the last video, we have seen answer to this question number 18. You can pause the video in between if you want. And then, which of the following catalyst is sensitive to temperature change? All biological enzymes are sensitive to temperature change. If you have fever, the enzymes won't work. Therefore, you should not eat heavy food. It doesn't mean you should not take food when you have fever. You should not take heavy food because enzymes are slow. When the temperature comes to normal, again enzymes will be active. Anyway, question number 20, which of the following exhibits specific activity in a catalytic reaction? All these fellows have specific reaction. Autocatalyst, you know, sometimes one of the product itself can act as a catalyst and speed up the reaction. For example, when ASH3 is decomposing, the arsenic, which is the product itself, can act as a catalyst. In permanganate titrations, MnSO4, one of the product itself can act as a catalyst. If the product itself can act as a catalyst, it is called autocatalysis. Question number 22, which one of the following is not an example of homogeneous catalysis? You can think it over. Which of the following is not involved in heterogeneous catalysis? Again, you can think it over. And then, which is wrong in case of enzyme catalyst? Again. Sorry, it has gone. Once you see these questions, this question number 26 to 27 are important. Geolites, you know, they are shapes specific and shape select, or they are used to convert alcohol into petrol, diesel, gasoline, whatever. In the reaction, product Mn plus to acts as self catalyst. These are the few questions on this topic, and this is the key for these questions. Question number 15 to 30, that is the key. So, you can check up yourself and try to do as many questions as possible. They are very simple. I wish you good luck.